Bible Time for Kids is made possible by support from these generous sponsors.
Look up at the sky. Look down at the ground. Look all around. And what do you see? A beautiful world that God made for you and me.
It's Bible time, it's Bible time. Let's sing and study and play. It's Bible time, it's Bible time. Let's have a wonderful day.
Welcome to Bible Time for Kids. Our show is one where you can come to have some fun and play and sing some songs and learn a little bit about what's inside the Bible. Come on. God has shown us again and again that He wants to talk to humans and have a relationship with them. But when humans became sinful, it made communication difficult because God is holy. That means God does not have any sin. So God is offended by sin. God chose certain people who offended Him less to speak His words for Him. They spoke what God asked them to speak. First, there were priests like Melchizedek, Aaron, and Hilkiah. Then there were leaders like Abraham, Moses, and Joshua, followed by judges like Deborah and Samson. So, who's next? The kings. Last week, we learned about the first three kings of Israel. Their histories are found in the books 1 and 2 Samuel, 1 Kings, and 1 Chronicles. Do you remember? Israel did not want God to be their king. They asked God to give them a human king, one they could see, one they could touch. But without the judges, who would speak for God? How would they know what God's plan was? Will God speak to His people through the human king? Well, sometimes God did speak to the kings of Israel directly, but more often God spoke to the kings through His prophets because the kings refused to worship God. Yes, the Bible teaches that God at this time provided prophets to His people. Playful wants to know, what's a prophet? Well, a prophet was a person who spoke for God, sort of like a preacher, to tell what God wants people to do, and sometimes to tell people what God wants them to know about the future. God would give the prophet a message for someone or some group of people, and it was the prophet's job to deliver the message.
Read all about it.
An important prophet at this time was actually the last judge. His name was Samuel. And boys and girls, you should know that the first time that God spoke to Samuel, Samuel was a very young boy. The prophets who came after Samuel were people whom God chose because they believed and respected God and chose to trust and worship Creator God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Sadly, many of their fellow Israelites had turned away from God. My favorite example that illustrates how God used prophets was the prophet named Daniel. Daniel was a young teen during the time of the Babylonian takeover. Daniel recorded his history in the book of Daniel, and you can find it in the Old Testament part of the Bible. Here is how Daniel records his story, and it begins in chapter 1. King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon ordered Ashpenaz, his chief official, to select from among the conquered Israelites some young men. They were to come from the royal family or noble families. They had to be handsome, intelligent, well-trained, quick to learn, and free from physical defects, so that they would be qualified to serve in his royal court. Ashpenaz was to teach them to read and write the Babylonian language. After 3 years of this training, they were to appear before the king. Among those chosen were Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, all of whom were from the tribe of Judah. The chief official gave them new Babylonian names. He called them Belteshazzar, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They impressed King Nebuchadnezzar more than any of the other trainees, so they became members of the king's court. No matter what question the king asked or what problem he raised, these four knew 10 times more than any advisor in his whole kingdom. God gave the four young men knowledge and skill in literature and philosophy. In addition, he gave Daniel skill in interpreting visions and dreams. One time, King Nebuchadnezzar had a bad dream, but he could not remember it. And he asked all of his Babylonian advisors.
Don't ask me.
What was it? What did it mean?
Don't ask me.
But none of them knew.
Don't ask me.
Then Daniel volunteered to pray to God and ask God what it meant. Daniel was able to describe and interpret the dream for King Nebuchadnezzar and gave him this assurance. It was God's message to the king. Daniel told the king exactly what he dreamed and how it was a message from God about his future and the future of his kingdom and the future of the world. Certainly, Daniel was God's prophet. Playful. Boys and girls, we can learn so much about God when we study the prophets and their prophecy. Next week, we will learn more about what happened in Israel when they decided to turn against God and how it's never a good decision to turn against God. It's just about time for crafts, but I'd like to invite the kids at home. Hey, kids,
come on!
Hey, kids, we have to take a break for some important messages, but we'll be right back with more Bible Time for Kids.
Welcome back, kids.
Now, kids at home, we'd like to sing another song for you. This song is called Rolled Away. And the kids are going to help us with some nice motions too. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Rolled away, rolled away, rolled away. All the burden of my heart is rolled away. Rolled away, rolled away, rolled away. All the burden of my heart is rolled away. All my sins had to go neath the crimson flow. Rolled away, rolled away, rolled away. All the burdens of my heart are rolled away. Hi, kids at home. We're joining with some friends today to do a little craft called stamping. And it's kind of fun because you can use just a little bit of paint and you can get into the junk drawer at your house and find all kinds of things, dip them in a little bit of paint, stamp them on some heavy cardstock paper if you have it, but any kind of white paper will do, and see what kind of shapes you can make on your paper. We have 6 different colors today, and you can use as many colors or as few as you want. So I'm going to ask each one of the kids to pick one thing first, and I'll just give a demonstration. Say you picked up this one. We're going to put it, dab it just a little bit in the paint, take some of the paint off of it, and then we're going to stamp it on the paper. Okay, you ready to try?
Uh-huh.
You'll see what different kinds of shapes you can make. Here's a bolt. So go for it, kids. See what kind of colors and shapes you can come up with.
Oh, give me that pearl. That is one beautiful pearl.
Yeah. That's a marble.
I meant marble.
Yeah, you can put the marble in the paint and roll it. There you go. You can roll it around on the paper and see what it does. Absolutely. I love it, Ella. Look, you made a star. Yeah, you did. That's awesome. Hey, that's cool. Look, he made a star too. Now I'll switch it up if you can. Use different colors, different shapes, and see what happens. Oh, look at that. It looks like you have monster feet.
Oh, no.
Oh, that's okay. Just get, you can get something different. You don't have to use the marble.
Oh, no.
Oh, no,
I lost
that's all
my
right.
Hands.
That's all right.
Oh, no.
You can go ahead and use a different color.
Yeah,
that's why we put gloves on, so if it got a little messy, it was okay. Everything gets thrown out at the end anyway. You can experiment with colors and shapes. Remember, using less paint is usually better when you're stamping, so that way you can see the shape better. You used the sponge there. Ah, now someone's gonna try an onion. A cut onion. I wonder what it's going to look like.
I did an onion with that. I think I might want to try the candy.
Okay, that sounds like a good idea.
I'm gonna try this candy.
Look at that.
I'm doing this candy.
Doing the piece of candy. I was wondering myself what that would look like.
Boop.
That's just like a crinkle.
Bop, bop.
Yeah.
Needed
that's all right. Just put it on the tablecloth. I'll clean them later.
I need green.
Okay, I'll bring the green
Let's
over.
See what this brown stinky thing is.
Playful's watching you all, and he's saying, "Whoa, that looks like fun. I wish I could do it."
You could if you wanted.
But he can't know because he would get. They don't make gloves to fit Playful. His hands are much too small. He would get very messy. I wonder what that's gonna do.
Stop.
It's hard to get that one flat.
And it's
hard
to get this one out.
It's
hard to get everything out of here.
Yeah. So all these things just came out of the junk drawer. How about try this one to see maybe how that would go with the green. Oh, you like the red. Okay. I wonder what it's going to do. Well, let's finish up here so that we can show our creation to the kids at home. I think that looks gorgeous. Why don't you just stop right there. I love it. I'm going to turn it. May I turn it around and show the kids at home? This is what this young man made. Isn't that nice? It's got some really groovy shapes going on there and colors. I'm really liking it. Are you ready to show the kids at home what you made?
Mm-hmm.
Not quite?
Not yet.
Are you ready to show?
Yep.
Okay, I'm gonna hold it up for you. I'll turn it around.
Can I have that foam, please?
Here, I'll...
What? Foam.
The foam.
Oh.
That dreaming.
Can you hold that up for the kids? There you go. Very nice. All right, thank you. Yeah, it is kind of fun. It's kind of messy, but it's kind of fun.
Yeah, it is.
It's fun making your gloves looking like this.
Kids at home, I would really recommend that you wear gloves if you do this activity. It's a little bit messy.
I'm making mine like the whole thing.
A little bit. It's hot.
Okay.
Compared to me.
I think we're going to wave goodbye for now while we get cleaned up. Kids, I hope you enjoyed this craft called stamping. It's a lot of fun. You can do it with watercolors, and you can do it at home with just any kind of watercolor paint, and it's a lot of fun. So thanks. Let's wave bye-bye. Everybody stop a second wave.
Bye-bye.
See ya.
See ya.
Here's mine.
Oh, thank you. Bye-bye. Hey, kids. We have to take a break for some important messages, but we'll be right back with more Bible Time for Kids.
Welcome back, kids.
Hey, kids, are you ready for some story time? Well, come on in. Playful. Boys and girls, I saw something. There was a big flash of light, and it looked kind of like a flower, and it sparkled like a waterfall in bright sunlight. And there were colors, red and blue and white, and then just as quickly, the sparks poofed and fell, and then they were all gone. What do you think, Playful? Well, Playful thinks maybe I saw fireworks. I have a question. Have you ever seen something that you never have seen before? How do you describe it? Do you tell about its shape, its size? Do you talk about its color? For example, the first time you saw fireworks in the sky, how would you tell me about it? What would you say if you had never seen fireworks before and you did not know the word for them? Today we learned about prophets and how God used them to speak his words of encouragement and warning. Prophecy in the Bible always tells a message from God, and prophets tell that story as best they can. But what they saw was sometimes something that they had never, ever seen before. When God first came to the prophet Ezekiel and spoke to him, Ezekiel tries to tell us about that experience in the book he wrote in the Bible. Here is some of Ezekiel's story. Ezekiel chapter 1, verses 15 through 21. As I stared at all of this, I saw four wheels on the ground beneath them, one wheel belonging to each. The wheels looked as if they were made of polished amber, and each wheel was constructed with a second wheel crosswise inside. They could go in any of the four directions without having to face around. The four wheels had rims and spokes, and the rims were filled with eyes around their edges. When the four living beings flew forward, the wheels moved forward with them. When they flew upwards, the wheels went up too. When the living beings stopped, the wheels stopped, for the spirit of the four living beings was in the wheels. So wherever their spirit went, the wheels and the living beings went there too. Well, what do you think of that, Playful?
Yes, me too. That sounds crazy and wild and sparkly and awesome. I think Ezekiel saw a bit of God's majesty, and he tried to tell us about it, but it was really hard to do. I have a friend who drew a picture for me. It reminds me of Ezekiel's vision and of God's presence in my life. When I read a story like this in the Bible, I think God wants me to know what He is like. I hope you will read the whole story for yourself in the Bible. And I hope you'll join us next week for another Bible Time for Kids. Hey kids, we have to take a break for some important messages, but we'll be right back with more Bible Time for Kids.
Welcome back, kids. Next time on Bible Time for Kids.
So the legs are going to be those rectangles we were talking about.
Playful. Have you ever lost anything? Children have to learn to ask for help. And children must learn to ask permission to do activities. It's time to sing a song with the kids at home. So let's sing Jesus Loves Me. And if you know how to sign it at home, kids, please sign it with us. Some of the kids here know how to sign. Are you ready? Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to Him belong. They are weak, but He is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Thank you. That was really nice. All my sins had to go neath the crimson flow. Rolled away, rolled away, rolled away. All the burdens of my heart are rolled away. The time has come to say goodbye, but don't cry. We'll be back another day. Bye-bye.
It's time to say goodbye for now. We've had some fun today. It's time to say